You can sign my balls.
All right. All right. With regards to Nathan's balls.
We're playing with pens.
Now you're playing with pens.
Oh, are we being recorded?
Yeah, we are.
Oh, being recorded.
Guess what we're doing today?
We're gonna be doing the adventures of Derek Dingo today. Okay, what's Derek Dingo? I need that explained, because you've talked about this a lot, and I now want to know what that is.
This is a large piece of my personal history. Not a good piece of my personal history, but a large one.
It all started in 1922.
And the Roswell incident.
Yeah.
I am not...
That's not 1922.
I'm not too happy about this, because it is what it is. But, yeah, I thought the name Dingo sounded really funny, so I made a superhero comic about a guy named Derek Dingo, and he, like, points his fingers like a cool guy, like finger guns, and he's, like, always smiling at the camera.
Dude, that's awesome!
And like, then he goes into, I want to keep the, don't show that again.
Do you want to keep the current color scheme? I think some reds and yellows might really liven things up.
All right, sure.
With Windows,
let's personalize that shit.
With Windows drapery, you can add
yellow.
Drapes.
Yeah,
oh,
looks
perfect.
Good. Yeah,
looks great.
Just make it yellow now.
That
it looks like it's old and dusty. Yeah. You know, you find like a product in a store that's like been there too long.
Yeah,
like it's that gross like yellow fucking sick color.
Yeah,
it looks like that on your desktop now.
Yeah,
yeah, it looks like I've been smoking too much from my computer.
Yeah,
but anyway, so yeah, he's always doing finger guns, and I thought at first that it was really funny. Then I tried to make it cool.
Oh, shit.
And it was never either.
Yeah. It's Garfield.
Pretty much. All right, so I'm going to ignore the prelude parts, because I made those after I made the series. And, I don't know, I might go back after a little while. But episode 1, The Adventures of Derek Dingo, volume 1, Dingus Khan.
That's a good name for the first one.
So this one reads left to right this time.
Oh, dude!
Oh, dude! It's an American comic.
We're in America.
So fucking like Western trash.
My first question right away is: does he have arms, or is that coming out of his belly button, or is that a leg?
Those are his finger guns right there. He's always doing them.
Just he can't not.
So he's got like this like disorder where his like arms are locked in.
Yeah, yeah.
Like his muscles locked out.
It's called Fonzie disorder.
Where he's constantly pointing at people.
Is actually like here by his nipples, and the arm just sticks straight out with no joints.
Yep.
It's like the next panel is like his leg is coming up and becoming the finger.
So he's like, Derek, what? Huff, huff, Dingus Khan. I'm on it.
Yeah.
You need... Say no more. Yeah. Dingus Khan, I'm on it.
So he's like, I'm on it. He runs out of the building. This guy's like, no, I was calling you Dingus Khan, you fucking asshole.
Some like fucking dude just walks up to you and says,
"So he turns
Khan.
Into Super Dingo." When he's in Super Dingo form, he gets the use of his arms and legs.
Yeah,
whoa!
And he also gets a cape
and a t-shirt. This is like Cool Cat.
Yeah,
wow, kids!
But that's actually not a t-shirt. That's just his belly.
I mean, yeah.
And so he's flying, and he sees what. A rectangle, and he's like, there!
There! That's the rectangle I was looking for!
That's the Dingus Khan!
Like, not here.
He's like, which building? Not here, and Dingus Khan.
What is this, fucking, like, Dora the Explorer for, like, really stupid kids? Like, not here, and Dingus... Like, they just put the fucking words on it.
Yeah.
Like...
What about all these other inconspicuous buildings?
Are they buildings, or is that just blank space?
Right?
I don't know.
So
he's like,
he's like, here! And it says, Dingus Khan.
Oh, man.
He, like, dramatically opens the door, and he's got, like, a shadow that casts across it. Yep. As to say that, that Derek Dingo, his arm stretches longer than the arm of the law.
He's a vigilante.
No one can escape his vigilante justice.
Here I am.
You're gonna get the D, and you can't stop me.
Who do you think he could be talking to?
Dingus Khan?
Dingus Khan!
What the fuck is that?
Super, like, Dingo, you are here.
Is that a head that has, like, a blood jet that's, like, keeping it off the ground?
Well, let me illustrate what it's supposed to be. But we'll say for our own headcanon, yes. Okay, that's his head. He's got squirrely eyes, a big, long, dumbass nose. His tongue's always sticking out. And big, dumbass ears. That's supposed to be a giant beard, his stick legs, and a sword.
Oh, now I see it. Okay, before I was just like, I thought he was just like a severed head that's just bleeding and floating around on the blood trail. Because the pressure is so high.
When I was this age, this was comedy to me.
Yeah.
A guy named Dingus Khan who looks like this, I'm like, that's funny.
Just like, he's got like this dumb mustache, I guess. Or maybe that's his, like...
Sure.
I don't know.
Dingo... just like in, like, Yu Yu Hakusho, it'll just have, like, a... It says Dingo Fist for what attack he's doing.
He's still got anime powers, even pow, back then.
Pow, zip, bang, or, like, the... It's like the 1960s Batman...
Yeah.
...things, and he's like... And... I imagine a big kanji symbol, just...
Yeah.
Dingo Fist.
And, like, and it looks... And it's like you hear, like, a howl.
Yeah. So he has Dingo Fist. I win!
It's great because, like, if you look at him long enough, he starts looking like an alligator.
Yeah. No, yeah. Totally. He's like, it's not over! And he swish, swish.
Damn it.
And... Ow, slice.
I like the face that's creeping off screen, like, just... using a hammer. He's like, are you okay, dude?
I will try. And he's like standing over his body with his leg on him like he's Caesar or something. Yeah. He's like, I will triumph.
It doesn't matter if I have pizza for a mouth.
Pizza or not, it's not over. What?
He's still like a generic like villain from like anime and shit.
Yeah.
Even in this.
Dingo power. He shoots Dingo beam.
Wow. He's just slowly turning into Ross Perot now. Sorry, kids out there. Ross Perot was a politician, and he's pretty funny. You should look it up.
He's
got big ears. That's his thing.
Dingo power. And then he's like... Ooh. And he...
It's like Dragon Ball Z shit no matter what. It's kind of awesome.
Yeah. Well, you should see how GBZ this gets. Like, for real. So then he does that, and he's, I turned back. You know,
what the fuck?
Tell, not show.
He has, like, a way better transformation scene for going to normal Dingo than he does going into, like, the super-powered version.
Take that. And that's the end of Volume 1,
Dingus Khan. Oh, my God.
So what do you think so far?
It's better than Ruby Volume 1, I'll tell you that.
It's got a lot of potential.
It's got a lot of potential.
I mean, like, this is dumb, but I feel like if you knew what you were doing and you, like, were grown up and took this, you could make it a really funny show, actually.
Yeah.
Like, this could be really great.
Well, this was Volume 1. This is my first... You know, it's kind of one of my first attempts at comics in general at all. It's going to remain dumb the whole time.
Oh,
don't get me wrong here. Yeah. I'm not going to tell you that it's like, it does get better. But in like, not a, the...
It gets better. It never gets good.
Yes.
Does Dingo ever find the perfect axe? That's my question.
He finds something. I can't tell you yet.
Oh, he finds his inner power.
The Adventures of Derek Dingo 2, Morbid Monster.
Uh-oh.
So he's back, like, he's back where he was, like, continuity here. He just beat Dingus Khan.
He's just leaving the Dingus Khan building.
Yeah, he's like, the horror! He hears over here.
What?
fucking what?
The horror. What?
Morbid monster.
There's just always some dude that just comes in and goes, there's a thing.
He just says the name of the thing. It's like, I know what that is.
Yeah.
I'll deal with it right away.
Yeah.
I know where, what, and how right now.
Yeah.
It's kind of like X-Cup. I love it.
So he's Super Dingo now.
He's like fucking Shazam. Not Shazam. What is Shazam?
So Dingus Khan, not here, and Morbid Monster.
It's like not here was on the other side.
It was.
So now there's more not here's.
Yep, just another one.
Also, his body has become a fucking like.
It's because not here. I found it hilarious. Oh yeah,
we're
totally
fucking like racing, like race people who like win like the Olympics and shit.
Yeah.
My body is now fucking stairs.
Canonically, that is the only not here building.
Ah, okay.
Because that matters.
It migrates.
Sure. Yeah,
it's a walking house.
There! So.
It's like again?
Yeah.
Is this like before copy and paste? He's still like.
Prepare to die.
Oh no, it's One Eyed Dingo.
Yep. It's Morbid Monster, and he's got a sword that has a bunch of M's on it.
Because the sword is morbid, I guess.
Yeah. He's like, I think that's Dingo power. He's going to do Dingo Beam again. Or something else?
I don't know. I think that's a lot of crinkle fries attacking a meatball.
Yep. Yeah.
And then action of some variety
occurs.
He's charging. Oh, shit, it's big ass dingo beam.
Oh, way bigger dingo beam.
And his like arm is getting strong.
Getting swolled up to do that one.
And there's the building. Boo.
Oh, and he really blew off the roof of the building.
Yeah, just, you know.
Classic.
Yep, just like in Secret Class of Ninjas. Was that all?
I like the drama that he's trying to build, and it's just like these big goofy googly eyes on him.
Yeah,
and it's like, was that all?
Man, you're gonna love once it gets past like the first arc.
Oh man,
there are arcs, and this is one of them.
Oh damn!
Die, and his sword starts sparkling.
Right in the balls.
You sliced my balls, and I died.
Oh my god.
10 minutes later, where am I?
You're in the balls no having dimension. It's right next to not here.
The hospital.
Like that kind of suspense for just like nothing, like no payoff. Like yeah, it's just
and then
it's
like have this dingo sword.
Yeah.
You're in the hospital, they just give you a fucking weapon.
Yeah.
It's like
this is a custom made sword for you.
It's like, look, you have to have proficiency in dingo based weapons, and you do, so
yeah.
You're the only one who does.
So it's like you die in Grand Theft Auto and you like go to a fucking hospital and you come out, and instead of having no weapons, you have the fucking rocket launcher and a tank. Like, right away, they just give them to you.
Exactly. And so he turns Super Dingo. I'm back. I got the MacGuffin in seconds. Dingo sword.
Oh, it's die. A D sword.
Sword duel. It says in parentheses, and it has a bunch of onomatopoeia.
It's a sword duel, guys.
So yeah, just turn your head. It'll be fine. You'll see it.
Just close your eyes and imagine Morbid Monster and Derek Dingo having a sword duel. He's like, next level. And I guess he can power up his dingo sword.
Oh my god. Have you guys ever seen the cartoon?
Oh god! And I bled all over it too!
Is that real? Man. That's real blood?
Yeah, it is.
And sweat and tears.
Oh damn! Yeah,
I've always had a problem with like picking at my thumb and stuff.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So yeah, that's my actual human blood on this page right now.
Damn! Yeah. This is like halfway to like a fucking ritual to bring this character to real life to torment us.
Yeah, yeah.
I wish you didn't say that out loud, because now I gotta start over, but I gotta find new people to do this with. Alright, cut.
They gotta just not know when to do it, or else you can't do it.
So he's like, hi-ya, bonks him on the head with the side of his sword. Take that.
Take that. I like how he just like goes from like fucking being, like, underdog to being, like, just this fucking, like, crudely drawn thing. Like, it looks like a meerkat. Like,
yeah. This is Volume 3, Part Page 1, Digitor.
Digitor? Are you going to fight Digimon now?
I'll go back to the base.
Which is the base is at not here.
And a transmission leaves Morbid Monsters building.
Uh-oh.
And not here is back where it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of, like, these people picking out their buildings and naming it after them instead of just picking not here.
Yeah.
Like, they should all be called, like, I would call all my building not here so, like, people wouldn't know that I'm the final boss.
Well, keep that in mind. So, oh yeah, yeah, the transmission goes out, goes to Dingo Incorporated, and it dispatches a spaceship.
Oh, yes, fucking spaceships.
And it lands here, it's like, the Dingo Mobile.
It looks like an eagle is, like, pooping.
Yeah.
Or something.
It's so fucking dumb. So, he docks into his own building. Where is everyone? I better turn Super Dingo.
Just in case. I better grow some arms.
Yeah. Where is everyone?
I'm in that same walkway again. Oh,
hi,
shit.
Hi, I'm Digitor.
Oh my god. Is it just like a fucking, like, Mario, bro? Like,
pretty much.
Pixelated?
Digitor. It's pretty much the main villain of the series.
Oh, shit.
When he comes around. What did you do to my friends?
I
sucked them into another dimension. And he has, like, this big, big orb thing.
Like, we didn't know.
What?
We didn't know we had friends until right now. And the second we find out they're our friends, he just goes, I sucked them into another dimension. So you don't have to draw them. And he's just like, no, I'm cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. Like, he just does not
think that, like, hookers say that. It's like, baby, I can suck you into another dimension.
There's a character, bringing that up, there's a character in fucking, like, Excel Saga that is that. It's kind of amazing.
Oh, so he turns Ultra Dingo.
Oh, he just had a form just in his back pocket, just
in case. Just in case. And what Ultra Dingo is he's not black, and he doesn't have, like, the shaded-in thing. He's pure white. Electricity jumps between his ears. And he has a little thing of armor. And he's got muscles.
Yeah.
Oh, and also the tail is just really sharp.
Yeah. As like hearing you describe it, because it sounds like you're having, like, a made up character fight with some other kid. It's like, oh yeah, he also has this.
So, the first enemy required him to turn a Super Dingo. The second one required him to get a sword. He's already Ultra Dingo before the fight begins.
Yep.
He just heard that his friends are, like, in, like, the Twilight Zone right now.
So he could have just done that for him last fight.
Yep.
And just won. Instead, he was like, he held his punches.
He can only turn into Ultra Dingo when he has just been informed that his friends have been sucked into another dimension.
I hope that's, like, canon.
It's a stipulation.
On paper, the only way he can do it.
Nope, not at
that
all.
That would be awesome, though.
Give me my friends! And it, like, it's his fist going down, and then Ben just... Basically, he's wailing on the guy, and that's Ultra Dingo Fist.
Oh, damn!
And that's way more powerful, because he punches more. Ouch. And then lots of his pixels go away.
Oh, shit, he gets in the big arms?
Yep, he gets in fucking big arms.
It's like a Tetris block is floating down into a robot.
Dingo power! So he shoots Dingo Beam, blows up his own base... Like a big corner of
Well,
his own
why
base.
Not? I mean, like, he needs that corner. Everybody's in another dimension now anyway, so let's just blow it up.
So, like, half of that robot's destroyed, and, like, a little bit of that head is left. Dingo Sword, next level. Like, so now he's at the most powerful he can be.
Yeah.
And so he does an attack called the Sword Dance.
So he just does the Sword Dance from fucking Pokemon?
I guess. So he, like, slices him up. There's still a few pixels up here, and then the big black eye pixel. And,
like, I mean, like, to your credit as a kid, at least you, like, made a villain that, like, could be like broken into pieces and easily drawn.
Yeah.
And also like not be super gory like the later ones where it's like fucking goddamn, like it kind of stabbed in the eye.
Yeah, a lot. Ow. Dingo bomb.
Oh, that's something. Oh,
shit.
Do.
He's going to throw an eyeball at him.
So.
Well, now what do you even.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
What do you even do now?
It's like, a skylight.
Yeah, you know.
Then just the black eye remains now. Transform. And then that thing's here for some reason.
Yeah.
No, he's this.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, dude.
Sword dance. Swish, slash, oh, cut. Oh,
he learns your moves.
Oh, hey. No. Power up.
I'm going to change it again into a new thing.
Dingo arrow.
I feel like I walked in on the end of the anime.
Right?
This is like episode fucking like 48 Three. Of Bleach.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
I just walked in on episode 48 of some shit. It's like, what the fuck is happening? Why does he have that ability?
Exactly. like Ultra Dingo, like Dingo in the third episode is already like in his third form doing like spirit bombs and shit.
Yeah, like that, like, yeah, that's like you start Dragon Ball Z and Goku's Go Super Saiyan and just killing Frieza. That's the first episode.
Yeah. Like, Raditz showed up, Vegeta dies, Frieza now.
Yeah, like, you didn't even get to see those other things. You just straight to Frieza.
He's like, who are you? I am Digitor 2000X.
Oh, damn. Oh, yeah. 2000X.
And he's got a big hole in his
That's
stomach.
That's 2,000 kisses.
Dingo arrow. Rapid dingo arrow.
Why is that making me laugh?
Well, it's like hug, 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 kiss. So he's just shooting a bunch of dingo arrows at him.
It's like broccoli.
Darn.
Aw, shucks.
And just the eye is left. It's broken. He can't transform again. Transform, so he's just gonna do it himself.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
I'm Digitor 3000 eggs.
Yeah.
Fuck X-ray. You. And he, Dingo loses. 3 minutes later, he wakes up.
This is like One Punch Man shit.
Yeah.
Like the one guy he fights in the first season that like just his power is just that he gets better after every defeat.
Yeah.
So like Dingo just does one shots, just one shots him, and then he's like, no, I got another one though.
Yeah. Exactly. Like 3 minutes later he wakes up, he's like, the dimension thingy.
Yeah.
Reverse.
How do you know how to do that?
And then all of his friends blow out.
So those guy, that guy that runs up and just tells Dingo a thing is happening are just all the people who are his friends who are faceless stick figures?
Yeah. Yep,
exactly. Isn't it great? Thank you. Now start rebuilding. Ha 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 ha. I'm serious.
Yeah.
Wow, what an asshole! Was that Dingo saying that, or no?
That was his friend.
That guy is the one who actually owns Dingo Base.
Yeah. He's the founder and CEO of Dingo Base, and you're just the face of the company.
Like, yeah. This fucking bizarre universe where everyone is like a nobody, a faceless suit, and there's like one guy who has superpowers.
I should also say that in those 3 minutes that he was unconscious, Digitor left him alone. Oh. And then he woke up and grabbed the dimension. And, like, sucked him into it.
Oh.
Oh.
Okay.
All right.
That's a weird thing to do.
So that was Digitor. Episode 4, Mosquitor.
Uh-oh.
Let's start rebuilding. 10 hours.
Ten hours.
That's a long time, dude.
No, well, I mean, maybe that is a long time, but long enough to build a fucking entire building.
He just used his Dingo build power.
Yeah, he turned Ultra Dingo. He can do that.
Yeah,
but look at this. Like, what was there is still there.
Yeah,
and it looks like he just like super glued it.
It does. Like, they went out and looked for the pieces and just like stuck them back on.
Yep. Yeah,
he just went to like Menards and like bought other parts of Dingo.
I need
base.
A new top of Dingo base. Like, oh, we're all out of those, but we do have top of Dingo Incorporated. Okay, we can use those then.
Yeah, sure. So
those should be compatible parts.
And then he paints over the line.
Yeah,
I do like how you went over and you did that though in the panel. That's actually pretty good.
Yeah,
because that's like saying that you even knew that was stupid and funny.
Oh yeah, there are a few things I was aware of. Some things totally not. It is done. He gets the fucking thing. The phone rings.
A blob on a block rings.
Yeah.
No, she mean Bodhi McBoatface?
Yeah.
It looks just like that shit.
Hello?
That phone is larger than his entire body.
He's like, hello? Dingo, it's for you.
You can tell it's the 90s because the phone is so big.
Mm-hmm.
Nah, dude. This is 2003.
Oh, damn.
Oh, shit.
What?
A cop car just came by outside with its lights flashing.
Huh. Is my car doing something?
No, you're fine. Hang on. I'm just going to go be curious, because I want to know if it's like the neighbors down the street who have been caught doing meth before.
Yeah.
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 Nope, it's not them.
All right.
Okay. I don't know.
I was, like, worried about my car because, like, I've already had enough shit.
Yeah, no, you're fine.
Okay, good.
It's not you. They wouldn't have his lights on to get you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's, like, minor ticket bullshit.
Yeah, they would have just left me a ticket. Like, I don't know they would have their lights on.
So he's like, hello, come to Mosquitor Building.
Is Mosquitor like Cheetor from fucking Beast Wars? Is he a Beast Wars monster?
He's like, all right, turning Super Dingo.
Let me just auto. You just always be Super Dingo and just go to Ultra. Like, why would you start as regular Dingo ever? Just because those finger guns are so sick.
Yeah. Well, you know, sometimes you don't want to walk around in your business clothes. Sometimes you want to wear your tank top and your sweatpants that are two sizes too big.
Yeah.
So it's that question, like, why doesn't Superman just be Superman all day? It's just like, well, sometimes he gets tired. No, he doesn't! He doesn't get tired! He has no reason to not be Superman all the time.
So he flies away in the Dingo Mobile. Which building? Mosquito.
I can't even read that.
Not here. Dingus Khan, Morbid Monster. See, all these black buildings are actually filling out with actual buildings
now. That's kind of great.
As more are. And that's Mosquito.
That's a good concept for like. Like doing what you did with the buildings is actually a pretty good concept for like a really cartoony fighting game.
Yeah.
Like, that's pretty good.
Like, they're all locked, and you have to unlock them.
But they're buildings, so it's, like, more stylish. It's not just, like, this is just a face.
Yeah.
I like that. It's the same shit. It's, like, this is great. I like how you have, like, tropes.
You are already here.
It's just a goddamn mosquito! Big googly eyes!
Oh, shit!
For God's sake, it's just a fucking... It shoots a laser beam!
And then he... No. look at what he calls the laser beam. Dingo power!
Yeah. What the fuck?!
He shoots Dingo beam at him.
Oh my God, why? Why is a fucking rare character in your fucking thing?
Yeah. But that's what Mosquito does. He sucks your blood and then he learns your moves.
It's great because we can tell now, like, this is good. This is like echoes from the other stuff you did where everyone just gets abilities because, like, they, like, fought somebody else. No, that's fucking. I'm thinking of Axe Cop. This reminds me of Axe Cop.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, Dingo Power. It's like, oh, shit. Well, fucking Dingo Power back. And then, kaboom. I can still use it, meaning that he doesn't take it away from him.
He can do it.
Cause suck.
Why's he sucking on a dick now?
just a big black dildo.
Huge elephant ass dick.
Yeah, why is my penis
actually,
being
no,
sucked
he's a mosquito,
by this
mosquito. It would be tiny.
Yeah, well, he sucked on Dingo, and Dingo was like
yeah, I guess he's a huge
mosquito. That's a huge mosquito.
Fair
which
enough.
Is actually terrifying, but it's just hilarious. It has big googly, like,
so he punches him, and he's, like, flying, like, barreling away.
Yeah.
Dingo soar.
Ow! Why does it make it... That's the best thing I've ever seen. The fucking mosquito wielding a sword with its fucking, like, nose, like, straw thing. Like, that's the best thing ever... This would make a great cartoon if you just, like, updated all this to make sense. Like, this would be really funny.
Oh, shit. Well, Dingo spray.
What is that? Is he going to pee on him? Like, what is that?
It's just using Dingo spray, and then he... Oh, fuck, that's too much for me. And he just turns back. Take that. Flies away. Lands into Dingo Incorporated.
Just goes back to finger guns mode, just so he can see. He always says, take that, finger guns. Yeah. That's what I was thinking. Like,
that was why I thought it was so funny.
This actually could be really funny if you made it, like, if you just, like, redid it. Like, this could actually be funny. Because the concept is...
I'm very surprised that that's your reaction.
I don't know why you don't think it's better. This is actually way better than you were making it sound.
Honestly. Well, because I didn't remember it.
It's bad, but like as a kid, it's pretty good because like a lot of the things that are going on in it, like it's like there are animation gags in here. Like the fucking mosquito was wielding a sword with its needle thing. Like that's actually pretty good. Like
okay,
like for a kid's show, that's great.
So this is Volume 5, Frumpy the Cross-Eyed Weasel.
Ah.
Any thoughts on that?
All I'm thinking about is this, like, phallic imagery, some more of that shit.
So there's the Frumpy building sending a transmission to Dingo and
every building has a fucking, like, radio tower on it.
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck?
Hello?
Oh, he just grows another arm, and it's like that one arm that's always pointing.
That one's also finger gunning because he has to.
Oh my god! Like that's like
just to show like, he's in his base form.
Like that's not funny doing it one time, but the fact that it's always happening is kind of awesome. Like that he even like, no one draws attention. His arm is constantly like straight out of his chest, pointing at something. And there's like you could even like throw a joke in where they're just like it's like Dingo, Godzilla's here. It's just like I'm on it. Hey, why are you always?
No, it would be Dingo, Godzilla. I'm on it.
Yeah. It's just like what? Like why are you always pointing like at me? That's really rude. It's like oh yeah, this is actually a condition. I have to point north.
Yeah.
All the time. Or like you could even have a visual gag where like he puts like a character puts Derek Dingo in his like base form in a pool of water and he points north.
Yeah.
Like, he just fucking spins around and points north. Like that's what I'm saying, this is pretty good. Like you could like really make some good jokes out of this stupid shit. Like
well, in the early ones maybe.
Yeah, I think the early ones are pretty good actually.
So he's like hello?
Hello.
To come to Frumpy Building. A battle awaits.
Ah, a batter arrange.
Super Dingo. That. Which building? There.
Yeah.
Like, even you were, like, getting done with that. It's always this
it's getting pretty formulaic.
That's what I think is great, that it has a formula. That's, like, huge.
I am Frumpy the Cross-Eyed Weasel.
It looks like a piece of toast with just a cross eye. It doesn't even look anything like a fucking...
God, this is so dumb. Holy fuck.
This is the best one we've read so far, I'll be honest. I love this.
Yeah. So he's like, I-beams!
What?
Yeah. I bounce off the walls and then move back.
This is so stupid. I fucking love it. That's the second joke, though. Like fucking Cyclops, like he gets his powers, but he also has like a fucking like he has like he's like lazy eyes, and he's cross-eyed and shit, yeah. And it's the beams come out of his eyes and they go like around the villain,
yeah,
because they fucking cross. Like the fact that you bounce off a wall to hit him is so good.
You know, before this, I did not expect laughter to be response to this.
This is really dumb, but it's actually really fun. This is a fun. This could be a fun thing for real. Like,
and it was intended to be a comedy.
Like, this is actually pretty good. Like, yeah. For fucking
at
like,
first,
like
so he does multiply. He shadow clone no juice.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
I love how just this guy named Derek Dingo just has, like, all the Dragon Ball Z powers ever.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that's what's great about it. It's like he's clearly just like I know, like, it's you're dumb, you were a dumb kid, you're just doing whatever you saw on TV, but like that's what the people are doing now. Like,
yeah.
Like there's a show called Lakewood Plaza Turbo, and it's this. Yep. Like, it's fucking this, but like with like a better story. Like,
yeah.
There's a character who has Goku's voice actor. Really? Like Kid Goku's voice actor, and the whole show is about them doing special moves. And one of the special moves is he, like, points his finger, and, like, a laser that looks like a finger gun comes out of his hand and, like, punches people. Like, that's what this is. That's nice. Why I'm saying this is pretty good. Like, it's...
So the three of the dingoes start... They all scream dingo power and just, boom, just shoot him with three different blasts.
Yeah.
And he's like, well, fucking super I-beam then.
It's so stupid.
Then he destroys two of his shadow clones. He's like, yeah, well, fucking Dingo Wave.
Like, oh, shit.
Like, and he's like, oh, shit.
Like, you made this like, a little bit better. Like, if you made this, like, better, like, this could, like, actually be a thing on, like, I could see this being on Cartoon Network. Like, a dumb random fucking comedy with just, like, this stupid character and just, like, bizarre shit. That's, it could actually work. Like,
he's like, I won 5 battles.
Okay. Level up.
That's good to know, Jake. Why is it so stupid?
But, and he has a fucking, like, digital, like, scoreboard. Like a basketball.
So,
Derek Dingo wins, losses 5-2. Look at that.
So, like, the fucking thing. So he just, like, out of nowhere just announces, I won 5 battles. And he goes home and there is a fucking basketball scoreboard with numbers on it.
Just, like somebody's keeping track of it.
Like, I can even see him opening, like, the scary fucking, like long shadow door he has all the time.
Yeah.
And there's just this basketball scoreboard that just turns on, and he's just like, I'm so close.
Yeah. Wipes his hand down. Okay, so that concludes arc one.
It's better
the Herald than... of the Golden Ultimate Shiny... No, I've got to come up with a better, like... I'll just call it the Golden Age.
The Golden Age.
Golden Age Derek Dingo.
Like, these, like, I legit think these aren't that bad. Like, as bad as you, like, as I mean, you made them, so you're way more ashamed of them than anyone else ever would be. But, like for what they are made by you at that age, these are pretty funny. Like,
alright.
Like, they're not bad.
Arc 2 now begins. And I will call this one The Banner of the Golden Gods.
Yeah.
That sounds like a good name for that.
Yeah. I agree.
I think the reason I like this one more than the other ones we've read is that it's way easier to see what's actually happening with the characters, even though they're drawn, like, not well. I know what they're doing most of the time.
Never mind about that.
Okay.
The Arc 1... This is the end of Arc 1.
Okay.
I forgot about this. This is Adventures of Derek Dingo Special.
Ah, it's the...
It's a 4-pager.
It's the after-school special.
Yeah. It's about the longest
one. I will start walking away from this staple.
Yeah.
I will start training.
Okay!
This is hard.
Just... Ugh. Is this, like, overly simplified? Kind of great. It's like he's, like, doing push-ups into, like, a pile of shit.
Yeah.
I was like, what is he doing? Like holding like a bunch of bees? Like, on
it says Super Dingo Fist down here. Then he does it again.
So is regular Dingo Super Dingo? Or is he Super Dingo now?
He's regular Dingo right now.
Okay, but he doesn't have an arm, like a big fat arm sticking out.
Well, I think if he's doing something with those arms, he gets a free pass. But anytime his arms would ever be idle, it has to be finger gunning.
Yeah.
Okay. Because I feel like that would have been a great opportunity for a joke where he just has that out while he's doing that. Like, he's doing push-ups and his arm is, like, stopping him every time he tries to go down.
Yeah. So he's, like, tied up by his legs and doing, like, upside-down sit-ups with a big dumbbell. And multiply. and he's like fighting himself, and he's got like big black eyes and shit now.
Like, he just goes up and pokes himself in the eye with his big stupid arm.
Like he multiplied and he just went like UFC on his ass, and he's like, they like have to cut his eyes open so he can see.
Yeah.
Like I love this. There's so many jokes he can get out of that stupid arm thing. Like, he could be like disarming a bomb, and then like, yeah, and then he's like, all right, all I have to do is cut this wire. He's like, just don't hit the red button. Like, just the arm just swings right into it the second he starts disarming it.
So he dissolves his other clone, turns Super Dingo, and he karate chops a cinder block and breaks it.
Oh, yeah. Damn.
He's like, energize, turns Ultra Dingo. 2 days later, after a lot of training.
Oh, damn.
I hope my training pays off.
And like, he's standing there 2 days later after it was a lot of training. This is the next panel. I hope my training paid off. So you don't get to see what happened. He just stands there.
This is like
you should have ended the comic right there. Yeah. It should just be the end where there's all of that build up and all that shit. And then it's just like, then it just gives you a 2 days later. I hope my training paid off. Credits. That's it. You don't get to see what happened at all.
I do like how like half, like we're about halfway down the page now.
Yeah.
And you got to see Derek Dingo's exercise routine. And then it says 2 days after more of that shit.
Like, whatever the fuck that even was.
So he turns Super Dingo, turns Ultra Dingo. That was easy. So now we can turn Ultra Dingo.
And now it's a little bit easier? Like, before easy. It seemed like he did it like that, like one panel transformation.
No, he had to know that his friends...
Oh, yeah. So you had to try to give yourself an excuse to ever go back to Ultra Dingo.
Yeah. So now we can just straight up go Ultra Dingo.
That's pretty funny.
I can turn Ultra Dingo easily. So he turns... Then that's his turning back into... I will defeat Digidor 3000X. I'll unlock him from that dimension and beat him this time.
Yeah. I'm gonna let him out so I can kill him.
Yep. That's it. Yep.
Oh, damn. That's not a very smart thing to do.
Because, you know, he was, like, locked in a dimension. He's gonna come back.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
He was like, all right. Come back here with the dingo. He just gets in the dingo mobile and fucks off.
So they let him out, and he's like, oh, shit. Okay, bye.
He just, like, steals his car and drives away. He's like, hey, fuck you!
He just gets into his fucking giant Dorito car.
And not here is where he flies.
Uh-oh, he's from
not
here.
No one's ever gonna find him now.
Yeah, that is I hope to God the next panel is just him standing outside of that scene. He's like, where did he go? Oh, shit!
Just, like, the big dramatic opening of the door with the shadow in every building, so, like...
He just doesn't try that one, and then a stick guy's got to roll in and be all like, hey, Dingo, try not here! It's like, that's retarded.
It's like, no, why would I do that?
You fucking idiot. Of course he's not going to be in not here. Who lives there?
I need an army, says Digitor. In Dingus Khan's building, I need a new sword. Here building has one, I assume.
Like, the Not Here building is where swords would be, even though nothing is there.
In Morbid Monster building. I will go to Not Here building to train so I can kill Derek. In Mosquito building.
Oh my god.
I will suck the blood of someone in Not Here building.
That's actually really good. That's actually really good, because, like, everyone makes up okay? some really...
Yeah, I'm going to be right back.
Oh, shit.
I might burp a little bit, but...
Oh, shit.
No worries. Well, you know.
I would, too.
Oh, this is making Nathan sick. But no, that's pretty good. Like, there's a setup there, too, and a punchline. Like,
Nathan's just barfing right now.
Like, oh, Nathan's what? Just barfing. Yeah, he's just barfing. I didn't even take my pants off. Are you ready for the barf?
I will sharpen my teeth at Not Here building, says Frumpy.
God damn it. I just like the mosquito, though, because, like, after all those, they had to, like, really stretch it to have a reason to go there.
Yeah.
And the mosquito is just like, I'll suck somebody's blood over there. I don't give a shit. I'm a fucking mosquito.
Opens the door.
don't know what you're talking about. These are pretty good. I like these.
Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Yeah, they all are like, well, I'm Digidor 3000X. I'm Frumpy. I'm Mosquito. I'm Morbid Monster. And I'm Dingus Khan. So all the villains we fought meet in one place. Who are your enemies? Like, it's like, hey, who are you? Oh, I'm this guy. Who are your enemies?
How many of your enemies are? Yeah, okay.
Who are your enemies? They're all like, yeah, Dingo.
Just Dingo. The only one we have.
I propose we join forces. Okay. I implore you to reconsider.
This is like fucking Sinister Six coming together, but like way dumber. Like, yeah. Like, man, I hate Spider-Man. Who else hates Spider-Man? Hey, you hate Spider-Man too. Let's all hate Spider-Man. Like, that's so stupid.
What's that?
I can't read what that says.
What the hell? Something the elite.
Complete the elite? I mean, like, it's, like, really falling apart after the third.
I don't know.
Are you doing all right, Nathan?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You done being queasy?
Done being breezy.
Okay, so what happened...
Yeah.
Was all the villains just serendipitously at the same time decided, I want to go to Not Here building right now. Wow. And Digitor's like, I need an army.
Yeah.
And so then they all just met, and he just, his army came to him.
Yeah.
It's just funny. They all, like, I do like that they all came up with, like, a really, like, I'm really stretching a reason to be in the Not Here building. Yeah. And then the Mosquito just pipes in, I'm going to go suck somebody's blood over there. Like, that's what I was saying when you left. For the audience, I'm saying it again, but, you know, fuck you. Just kidding.
No, they're all like, alright, yeah. So they paint over Not Here, and says, Elite.
Why would you do that? Now he's gonna check that building. You should have left that. You should have left it saying Not Here.
I do like how there's just an abandoned building that nobody's inhabiting, that just says Not Here. Like, you don't want this building.
That is such a fucking, like, cartoon-ass thing. Like, I can see that in fucking Sam and Max, like, or a fucking, like, adventure game.
The Elite. Oh, that's it. I will call ourselves... Let's call ourselves the Elite. Okay. The Elite plans.
The Elite plans.
It's in one of these buildings.
That one building that's new, I won't check yet, though.
Dingus Khan building. No one's here. Morbid Monster.
Oh my god, you just trolled the fucking thing.
Mosquito building. No one's here. Frumpy building. No one's
here.
Oh,
even kept in the fucking sun shining in through the hole in the wall up there.
Wait.
On the second panel, I think. Or third one. One of these.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you kept the whole... That's fucking great.
Yep, that's still there.
Yeah, how is it these are better than your later ones? I think it's because you were trying to be more serious in those ones, and these ones are like you're way better at making these funny.
Yeah, yeah.
Than you are at the drama.
Where's Not Here building? Surprise. Where is that? I'll go look.
Yeah, what the fuck is that? Let me go look in that building.
Dingo!
Surprise!
You have joined forces, Super Dingo, Ultra Dingo. What's that? And then Digitor's like, that's Ultra Dingo.
He's just like, that's Ultra Dingo.
Yeah, it's a thing.
It's fine.
He's stronger. He's going to kick all your asses.
Yeah. It's fine.
You will fight.
You will fight.
You will fight my team.
As I'm being slowly eroded away by time.
They all scream, battle, as they run in.
Yeah.
Dingus Khan's, like, ultimate technique, soing doing doing.
What the fuck is that?
It's soing doing doing. And it's where he, like, moves his sword like an infinity symbol somehow.
I don't understand, but I will go ahead and
just... He gets, like, slashed. He's like, ow! And he's like, Dingus power! And he's using Dingus beam at the end of his sword.
Oh, shit.
Ow! Fuck!
Yeah,
like,
no, it hurts.
Then he's like, oh, Dingo Beam 3000X.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, 3,000 eggs.
But I guess, I mean...
You are defeated.
He just tells... Like, there's a piece of ash on the ground.
In the shape.
You just tell it... You just murdered that guy.
Sword wind from Morbid Monster.
Whatever the fuck that...
Die, and he's just slashed all over. He's like, Dingo Sword, next level, and beyond!
Oh, no! He's Buzz Lightyearing his attacks!
I hope his training pays off.
Yeah, nice. I hope my training pays off.
Ultra Slash. I don't know who's doing Ultra Slash. Oops. You are defeated. Hey, I died.
That's awesome. Like you do the like he even says defeated like it's a fucking 90s cartoon where they couldn't say death or died or killed. Yeah. And then the guy says, no, I'm dead. Yeah. Stupid fucking censor. I'm dead. This is what death looks like. I have been like...
Look at me.
I have been split into fucking eighths at this point. I haven't been quartered. I've been put into eighths. Yeah. I'm dead.
I am dead. Look at me. I'm dead.
You are defeated.
I like how he says it, though.
No, that's actually pretty great.
You're defeated. Suck Dingo Bomb.
God damn it. I just want to suck somebody's blood over it, not your blood.
That's not right. Like this. Oh!
His eyes balloon he's out like, even
he's
more.
He's like, no, that's not a Dingo Bomb. This is a Dingo Bomb.
God damn.
He's like, you are defeated.
You killed a Kremlin.
Aiming laser.
Okay.
How, so...
Oh, because his eyes are fucked up, he can aim now. That's what makes him actually
like,
good.
He has some weird little tracker thing. He's like, I don't know... something. He's like, I can't see, because he sees double.
Oh, is he used to... Oh, because he's like, because he's just because he's cross-eyed, he's not doing the thing.
Yep.
I thought he was doing that technique, but actually that's pretty good, because that's like, yeah, that made me think, so he's... that made me think he was doing the double thing, but he's actually just stupid, and his eyes don't work.
And still missed.
I gave me an aiming fucking computer,
he shot
and I still can't hit them.
He shot at the wrong one that he saw in his double vision.
Oh my god.
Which is why it's just better to just fire it.
I like Frumpy Weasel, whatever it was.
Yeah,
is he?
Frumpy the Cross-Eyed Weasel.
Frumpy the Cross-Eyed Weasel is probably one of the better villains that you have here.
Yeah.
Like, just because of, like, his whole thing where he, like, shoots lasers from his eyes, but he's also cross-eyed, so they don't go where he wants.
Yeah.
Like, that's like that level of, like, fucking, like, having a superpower that, like, would be good if this wasn't a thing also.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, only invisible when people aren't looking shit. That's what he has.
He just punches him a lot with the Ultra Dingo Fist. And he's like, fine, super I-beam. And boom, takes him by surprise again, because Dingo never learns.
Well, no, ever. I mean, his training didn't pay off.
Please. He's like, ow. Dingo Star.
Oh shit, he's just threw a fire symbol.
Yeah, but watch. Okay, I'll describe it when you see the result.
Oh,
you
God.
Are defeated. Basically, it's a cookie cutter.
Yeah.
That he's shooting at high velocities.
And then you got this asshole with a bean for a head.
He's like, I look forward to facing you. You ready? I was built ready.
Yeah. I mean, that's how robots work.
So he just kind of made short work of all the villains.
Well, of course. I mean, it's like the Powerpuff Girls. They're just going to win.
Let's go! He's like, boom, I don't know what's happening here, but...
Spiders.
Rapid beam. He's just shooting him a lot, and he's like, gets shot. He's all... Well, you know, there's that.
I know, like, but it just this makes me laugh every time.
He's missing, like, teeth, and his eyes black. And he's all hurt still. He does Dingo Fist Blast, which is...
That's what I do every night.
He's like, blast, as he lost his arm, because that's just what you say. And he, like, focuses his energy and shoots an X-ray, which was the same technique as before. And
pizza. You blew up the whole town into pizza.
With stuffed crust and everything.
Yeah, man.
Stuffed full of death.
And he's like, oh, fuck. What? How do you think I got here? Oh, yeah, he's flying now.
Oh, well, of course. I mean, because he's so powerful, or the explosion, or I don't know.
Because his training paid off.
Oh, yeah, that was it. He's like, you can fly? He's like, how do you think I got here? You stole my fucking car.
Why does he have the car if he can fly?
Well, same reason you have a bike if you can walk.
You know, when you put it like that, I'm fucking stupid.
Dingo blaster, and I don't know what the hell that is. It's one of the circles with the blast at the end of it. He's like, oh shit, I just have like, oh yeah, and then it turns into a jet so he can fly.
The removal of my legs made it so I could just blow fire out of that area and fly away now.
Yeah.
Like, wait, what?
I'm very versatile. So he's like, okay. Oh yeah, he does Stinger 3000X, which is like a very thin beam that, like, hurts him on his hand.
Oh, damn, not my hand.
He's like, ah.
Oh, I can't
feel. And now it's a little charred.
Not my hand. Now I'm gonna do finger guns!
Dingo kaboom.
Uh-oh, not a dingo kaboom.
Also, his arm got super swole.
Yeah, yeah. like cancer his, swole.
Yeah, his, like, burned, ashed up hand, too.
Oh, that is the finger gun's hand. It's even doing a finger gun.
He's like, boom. His head spouts a jet. He's like, oh.
All my body parts just can, like, shoot a fucking jet.
Super spark out of his eye. Like, he is not done yet.
Skeleton. Oh, no! I like how he's got the dumb grin.
Yeah.
I like how he went the extra mile to, like, make the skeleton look like it would go inside of that weird thing you drew. Yeah. That's actually really great. It's pretty good.
It's like, shit. All right, Dingo Power, shoots a bean. Oh, poo.
He says. Fuck, what?
He shoots Dingo Arrow, destroying the thing, and sparks fly everywhere.
The final picture.
Take.
Destroy.
That.
Mega Man.
Then he flies in, concluding arc 1.